Hi, this is Bryce Smith from the SAS Accessibility Team. Here at SAS, we've created innovative technology so people with visual impairments and blindness can independently explore network diagrams. In this video, I'd like to show it to you. First, we'll take a look at some of these features, and then we'll demonstrate an example as we investigate insurance fraud using Visual Investigator 10.8. I'm using the JAWS screen reader. I have Visual Investigator 10.8 open in Chrome, and I've turned on the setting to enable non-visual access to data visualizations. This setting is persistent, which means I won't need to turn it on again. From the alerts page, I've opened an alert and then navigated to the network diagram for it. Visually, there's a blue dot at the center of the diagram on screen. It represents my virtual location diagram. I can move this virtual location using the arrow keys. And as I press the arrow keys, JAWS tells me where I'm located in the diagram and the number of objects around me.
291 units north, showing 37 of 37 objects. 291 units east, showing 37 of 37 objects.
I can press 0 to reset my virtual location back to the center of the diagram.
0, moving to center, showing 37 of 37 objects.
People who are visually impaired or blind often use a cane to navigate safely and effectively in their community. They do this by reaching out with the cane to find and explore objects in their environment. From my current location in this diagram, I can reach out and sweep what we call a virtual cane around this diagram to explore nodes and links. I do this by pressing the page up and page down keys. When my virtual cane finds an object, JAWS tells me the name of the object, its distance from me, and the direction to the object.
Page down, 980880695 2, business account, 1 adjacent, 1 expandable, 564 units at 12 o'clock. Page down, link accounts, document link, 2 adjacent, 474 units at 1 o'clock.
As I find objects with the cane, pay special attention to the sounds they make. The nodes and links make different sounds depending on whether they're in front, behind, or to left or right of me, as well as how far away from me they are. You can also hear the difference between a node and a link. A node makes one sound, and a link makes two sounds, which represents the two nodes it's connected to.
Page up, 980880695 2, business account, 1 adjacent, 1 expandable, 564 units at 12 o'clock.
That's a node with one tone.
Page down, link accounts, document link, 2 adjacent, 474 units at 1 o'clock.
And that's a link with two tones. When my virtual cane is touching an object, I can move my virtual location to it by pressing enter.
Enter, moving to link accounts, document link, 2 adjacent, showing 37 of 37 objects.
If I want to know more information about where I'm at and what's around me, I can press the slash key. We call this the where am I command.
Slash, your coordinates are 661.257, 28.812. You are at link accounts, document link, 2 adjacent, showing 37 of 37 objects.
When I press slash, you may have noticed there were 37 objects in this diagram. I can filter the diagram by pressing the F key to show me things like all objects, all nodes, or even just adjacent objects or adjacent nodes that connect to the object I'm located on.
F, all nodes, 19. F, adjacent objects, 2.
All these features enable me to get a better sense of what's around me in this network. All right, so now I'm going to use JAWS to investigate this network diagram and find any suspicious connections between entities. First, I'll reset the diagram by pressing 0, and then I'll filter it to only show me nodes.
0, moving to center, showing 37 of 37 objects. F, all nodes, 19.
I'm going to go ahead and sweep my virtual cane counterclockwise a few times with the page up key.
Page up, 948214076811, business account, 1 adjacent, 504 units at 11 o'clock. Page up, 456 coffee shop, business customer, 3 adjacent, 251 units at 11 o'clock. Page up, 400, page up, 044-800-273920, telephone, 1 adjacent, 682 units at 9 o'clock. Page up, Dr. EFG, business customer, 3 adjacent, 501 units at 8 o'clock.
So here, my virtual cane has found a node at the doctor's office. Let's go ahead and explore this node a bit more. I'll jump to it with the enter key.
Enter, moving to Dr. EFG, business customer, 3 adjacent, showing 37 of 37 objects.
I'm going to set my filter to adjacent objects, so that when I sweep the cane, I only find objects connected to this doctor node.
F, adjacent objects, 3. Page down. Link accounts. Document link. 2 adjacent. 104 units at 2 o'clock. Page down. Link business. Resolved relationship. 2 adjacent. 99 units at 6 o'clock. Page down. Link telephone. Resolved relationship. 2 adjacent. 122 units at 10 o'clock. Page down. You are a Dr. EFG. Business customer. 3 adjacent. Page down. Link accounts. Document link. 2 adjacent. 104 units at 2 o'clock.
So, when I used the cane, I noticed there's a couple links connected to this node. One of them is a link to an account that seems interesting. So I'll move my location to it.
Enter. Moving to link accounts. Document link. 2 adjacent. Showing 37 of 37 objects.
Now that I've found the link for the account, I'll sweep my cane to find the account and then move to it.
Page down. 29104408576. Business account. 2 adjacent. 104 units at 2 o'clock. Enter. Moving to 29104408576. Business account. 2 adjacent. Showing 37 of 37 objects.
From here, I'm going to switch my filter to only show me adjacent nodes. This will allow me to find nodes that are connected back to this account number.
F. Adjacent nodes. 2.
And I'll sweep the cane to find nodes.
Page down. QRS Pharmacy. Business customer. 3 adjacent. 257 units at 2 o'clock. Page down. Dr. EFG. Business customer. 3 adjacent. 208 units at 8 o'clock. Page down. You are a 29104408576. Business account. 2 adjacent.
I heard there are two adjacent nodes. And I've learned that this account number is used for the doctor's office and the pharmacy. This seems suspicious to me. So next, I'll reach out to the Secretary of State to make sure there's common ownership of the doctor's clinic and the pharmacy location. And if there is, I'll group them together to make my network easier to understand. This was a quick demo for how to explore a network diagram with a screen reader using Visual Investigator 10.8. We hope it was helpful.